you, God, for another day's journey, another year, another hour, another minute, another second. Lord, we give you praise tonight. Lord, we honor you tonight. God, we lift you up tonight. God, we magnify you tonight, and we glorify you tonight. And God, we want to thank you in advance for what you're going to do for us in 2015.
Yeah. start to think and wonder about all the greatness and goodness of God. And I started to think about this season as it began to start. And I was so happy and jovial because this is the time of year we talk about Christ. And then things happen. I lose a nephew one week. I lose a brother-in-law the next. And I was starting to wonder, in a season that I am jovial, I got so much pain, Lord. But then the word reminded me that these things are not comparable to the glory of Christ. Because we're walking through this barren land, but we won't be here long. And so I began to conjure up myself and say, I'm not worried about this no more. I can't affect the things that happen around me daily. I have to depend and lean on God and His understanding. So my testimony to you today, church, is that sometimes suffering in Christ is so much better than trying to do things on your own. So I'm looking for somebody who wants to share a testimony today that'll free somebody.
Yeah.
Somebody that can be able to hear what you gotta say and say, I can go on another day. So I'm looking for somebody who will stand up and say, for God I live, for God I'm surely willing to die. And somebody who will say, I got a little word in my life, and I'm not worried about things tonight. I'm looking for somebody who will just tell Jesus, thank you for 2014 as I move forward to 2015. It's testimony time. Anybody has a testimony tonight they want to share with us? Just stand and we're going to send someone to the mic and let you tell what you want to tell to the glory of God for this year. Anybody, don't be ashamed. Reverend McGowan, I want to share with us.
I just want to just stand and just say, to God be the glory. He is good no matter what. I just heard you say that you lost your nephew and some other member of your family. It also happened to me. But God is still good. I remember leaving here, I think about 2 weeks ago, on a Sunday, got home, and my husband was sick, and I was up all night with him, and about 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning, I said, honey, it's time to go to the hospital. You know, you're sick, there's nothing we can do. And he agreed, and 3 days later, he passed away. And all of that, God is still good. In the suffering, God doesn't want our family to suffer. So I know he's home with Jesus. A week before that, my brother lost his wife. I couldn't even, you know, help him and just grieve with him in his time because I was dealing with so many other things. His sister, my husband's sister, showed up for the funeral from California, and she wound up in the hospital for 5 days. So I was there in the hospital, back and forth, staying all night at the hospital, hoping that she would just make it and be able to make it home. And all of that, God is still good. And all of that, he is still good. I do know God, and God knows me. My children had, you know, accepted the fact that the Father is God. And we know that God is our Father, and he is here with us, and he's still taking care of us. He gave me that word, and I recognize that. In 2014, it was a good year, and especially those of my family that went on home, because prior to my sister-in-law leaving, I had to go to Milwaukee for my auntie's funeral. And that was 3 weeks before that. So it was a lot that was going on. But that is no sorrow in God when our loved one go home to be with the Lord. I think I heard a preacher said that If we really, really, really understood what Jesus said when he said, I go prepare a place for you, eyes have not seen, ears have not heard what God has in store. So he said, if you really know, you'll probably get a, try to get a 747 to get to heaven. So I recognize that they're all gone and they're in heaven. So I know one day I will be with them. But I just want to encourage all of you who may be going through some things, and you know you have relatives that are sick, and you're still trying to, you know, pray that they will make it through. And sometimes they're praying that, would you just let me go, because I want to go home. So we just have to, you know, give it on to God and let him take care of it, and recognize that God is still in control, and he still loves each and every one of us. All we have to do is still trust God. And I just praise him today, even so, and I'm looking forward to 2015 because he's still in control of 2015. So to God be the glory.
Want to stand up tonight just to give God the glory because he's worthy. And I so thank God for 2014, and I so thank God for not showing me what was in store for me in 2014, because I don't know if I could have endured. But God gave me some words, and he gave me 40 healing scriptures to stand on. And it says, one of them says, fear there not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. Yea, I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with my right hand of my righteousness. And that's just one of the 40 scriptures that God gave me to stand on. When last March, I went to the doctor, and we had some type of growth under my right arm. And doctor went in, said, oh, it's probably nothing, went in, took it out, went back. They told me there was a rare form of cancer there. He wanted to do a surgery in April. God took my husband and I, he wasn't the one. I went to another doctor. She said, I can't help you, but I'm sending you out. I was told that I possibly would not have an arm. After the surgery, went down to Seattle. I'm trying to tell you a long story in a short amount of time, but I so thank God for his grace and mercy. Everything that they told me that could possibly happen didn't happen. I'm standing here today. I could barely raise my right arm. I want you to know tonight I stood praising with that right arm. I have the use of that right arm, and I just thank God for his grace and mercy. Want to give God the glory and let you know, if you're facing something, don't give up. Look to the cross, don't look to the left, don't look to the right, but keep your eyes on Jesus, because he's our healer, he's our redeemer. So trust him. Amen. 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 Truly, truly, you can be excited
about that. When man says no, Jesus says yes. If God has carried you through 2014, I want you to stand on your feet. If you think God got you through 2014, you didn't do this on your own. See, somebody sitting here right now just heard a prayer break, and we sat down with that thing. She said she's the most blessed woman there. Oh my God. I want to stand on your feet. Somebody is expecting to get somebody. I want to know that there's another testimony out there, because God is carrying somebody through 2014. Amen.
Good evening, everyone. I just want you to remind you that it's past October 7th, made a year that I stopped smoking. I've been smoking for 55 years. Now, I'm going to wait until October 7th, 2015, so I can stand up and tell y'all again that it made it to me. I know it, man. Amen. But we know how we definitely shot. And, you know, when you got a relative playing football, and you got a touchdown, make a good tackle, man, you get in one of the stadium and running, people say, man, we should do the same thing in here. About a couple of months, it's gone. But God is here all the time. With a 24/7, Lord, I got 5 brothers and a sister and a father that's gone, and the oldest one, my dad, was 56 years old. And man, when I turned 57, I wanted to jump high of this building, but I ain't had no room. I just want to thank him every time I see a birthday. A lot of people want, I don't want to get old. But how you think you gonna keep on living and don't get old? I don't hate nothing, but that statement, and I hear a lot of times from our younger people. You got to get older to be able to stand up here where I'm standing, and all the older ones, the older than me, I want to get where they are. And I hope they don't let me catch up with them. Keep on living forever. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
All my children and my grandchildren. I have 5 healthy, beautiful grandchildren, and I thank God for each and every one of them. Thank God for my children, they help me. I thank God for all of my family members. I thank Him for everything that He's done for me this year. You know, this year, they just fly by these days. You know, time just fly by. But I just thank God for every situation that have arrived in my life, this year and up to this day, that He's always been there carrying me through. And I just, you know, He said if we don't praise Him, the rocks will. And ain't no rock gonna praise Him for me. I just thank God today for His glory, for His mercy, for His mercy, I thank Him for His vision, I thank Him for health, I thank Him for strength, I thank Him for each and every one of you that's praying for me. Continue to pray me. This year, my goal this year is to do better, to get closer,
yeah,
to be more involved. You know, we don't know. We only have the day. And so my desire is to give God more this year than I gave Him last year.
Amen. Amen. One more before we close out. You got something to tell, we want to hear.
I just want to give an honor to God. And December 5th, I was, it was 7 years ago that I had a stroke. I had a stroke at 48, and right now I'm 55. I'll be 56, but the Lord let me see it today. I have good and bad days, but I'm just so thankful and so grateful. I was here last Sunday, and I promised Reverend Blackburn I'd be back tonight. I wanted to bring 2015 in church. I had a rough year. I was just in D.C. 3 weeks ago. I have a favorite aunt. I go see her every time I'm there. I was there for Thanksgiving. I didn't go see her. She died that Saturday after Thanksgiving. And I had a nephew. I had a niece that graduated that Tuesday before Thanksgiving from nursing school. She'd been in nursing school for 4 years. And her brother died that Saturday before she graduated from nursing school. So it just seems like I had so many tragedies at the end of this year, you know? And before I could get out the door to get here tonight, it just seemed like the devil was trying to stop me. I left the garage door open. I had to go back home to get that. I left my phone. I figured you always need your phone. You just never know what happens. When I got halfway here, I got on the Mitchell. I realized I didn't have a cane, so I'm here without a cane. I made it. So, and you know what? Like I said, I was here last Sunday. My eyes was closed shut. And so I'm here, and I'm just thankful to be here, and I'm going to have a good year in 2015. And I hope with the Lord's help I'm going to live another year, you know, and I can look at the glass half empty or half full. And if you look at me, you never know I had a stroke, because I take care of myself, and the Lord is bringing me a long way. And just keep praying for me and my Cofield family. Just keep us in prayer. Thank you.
Because is a joint teacher. And every other Monday I'm off. So every other Monday I get to rest after I finish with the children. And I talk with the teachers because I don't know how to die. I just do it for a few hours on Sunday and I'm exhausted. And I go home. So I just thank God. I thank God for the ones that are part of the children's church and are working with the children's church. I thank God for each and every one of the children. And I want you to know that I just pray for each and every one of you. I don't call you by that because we are all a group. You're all my children. When you do stuff, I feel proud of them parents. And I got a chance this year also to have my children, my grandson. He came one Sunday and he ended up being in a play for a little play that they had last Christmas play. And he was just so happy and he was like, I'm gonna play. He had word or anything, but he wanted to be in it. I thank God for it because they made him feel welcome and wanted to be a part of it. He wanted to know who won that. He wanted to learn those Bible verses with those talents. I thank God that he allowed my grandchildren to do it. But I thank him also that my mother, I think that my daughter is here with me tonight. I thank him because it's so much. It's little to other people, but it's a great thing to me. I just thank God for it. I thank him again for each and every one of you. Thank you for the one that have been giving me stuff. Challenging. I mean, you can, one piece of bone, it's agreeable. It's just a piece of bone, but it's something they want.
We thank you for your time. So, without more ado, though, this ends the testimony. I'll turn it back over to the hands of the dance team for the children.
Let you know I'm out of time. And just tell me your name, let you know I'm out of time.
Jesus hasn't done anything for you in 2014, if he's done something for you, then you got something to praise him for. Go ahead. In Joshua chapter 1 verse 9, Moses died, he's off scene, and something, a new leader is emerged, Joshua. And there's some words in Joshua chapter 1 that I'd like to share with you, amen, because I believe it's right where we are at this present time, amen. 2014 is about to fade away in the rearview mirror, and we're about to enter into a new year where there is new mercies awaiting each and every one of us. If you have your Bible, I'm going to ask that you turn with me to Joshua chapter 1. Amen. And, you know, all good and perfect gifts come from above. The Bible lets us know that. Amen. So everything that you need, amen, going into 2015, you can find it in the Word of God. Amen. There is nothing that you could ever need, you could ever desire, or ever want, that you cannot find in the Word of God. Therefore, verse 8 of Joshua 1, amen, reads as thus. This book, amen, the Word of God, of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. Now, that comes with a provision. Amen. Look at what God says. If you do not let this book of the law depart out of your mouth, and if you meditate on it day and night, if you would observe to do what is written in the Word of God, God has a promissory note for you. And look what he said, and for me, for that matter. He said, for then thou shalt make thy way prosperous. I don't know about you, but I like that word. Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I'm declaring prosperity for 2015. I don't know about you, but I'm declaring that I'm going to have good success in 2015. Every head bowed, every mind on Jesus. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for your word, Lord. Father, it is your word that got us to this place. 31st day of December in the year of our Lord 2014. And God, if we even expect to see the clocks strike 12:01, God, we know that it's going to be you that did it. God, it is your amazing grace that has brought us this far. God, you kept us, oh God. You filled every void, Lord God. You provided every need, Lord God. Amen.
Say yes. My soul says yes, Jesus. My soul says yes. My soul says yes. My soul says yes. You say there is more than I require. There is more than I require of thee. He's calling you higher. There is more than I require of thee. He said, don't be afraid of men in the faces. Don't be afraid, don't be afraid, don't be afraid. Hey, hey. He said, I'm
yeah. comes out. We just need to claim our inheritance. It belongs to us. And that it has been given to us. The Lord shall open unto thee his good treasure, the heaven to give the rain unto thy land in its season, and to bless all the work of thine hand. And thou shalt lend unto many nations, and thou shalt not borrow. Amen. And the Lord shall make thee the head and not the tail. And thou shalt be above only, and thou shalt not be beneath. If that thou hearken unto the commandment of the Lord, thou God, which I command thee this day, to observe and to do them. It is always in our best interest to do and to live holy, to do what God has called us to do. No matter how things may look or appear to be, they look like things ain't gonna get right by us doing right, but we need to get right anyway. For God can share testimony. God, I'm gonna share testimony as God has shared, that he might not come when you want him, but he's always.
Yes, sir.
The Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit bears witness that we are the children of God. We are the children of God. We are his children. His children. Amen. Amen. Our God. He's our daddy. Our God. We are the children of the Most High. And the Holy Spirit bears witness that we are. For the Holy Spirit quickens our heart with the perfect knowledge and the complete confidence that we are the children of God. Yes. We have been born again into the royal family of Jesus Christ. For the Spirit sheds abroad the love of God in our hearts. He spreads the knowledge that God loves us and spreads it all through our being. For we feel him, we sense his presence, we sense his guidance. We know that he walks with us, we know that he talks to us, we know that he opens doors that no one can open. We know that he's a healer, we know that he is a way maker. We know that anywhere we are, there he is, that we are the children of the Most High, and he wants all of us. He wants only what's best for us. But if he wants only what's best for us, why do he allow us to go through these things that he allows us to go through that seem to bring us so much hardship? Well, how are folks going to know that God is God unless he allows somebody to be used by him so they can see you and say that God is able? For the Spirit is the earnest of the guarantee that we are the children of God. We make New Year resolution. I'm going to lose 50 pounds, you see. We make New Year resolution. I'm going to quit smoking this year. We make New Year resolution. I'm going to go to church every Sunday this year. Resolution after resolution after resolution. And we try to do it within our own strength, with our own power. We may get through this year with a New Year's resolution, with our own strength. But next year, you'll be back doing the same old thing. Amen. Amen. The Spirit is the seal or the guarantee that we are the children of God. Anybody have any doubts tonight? If you have accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, if you believe that He died, rose again, and declared that He is Lord, amen? He said, the scripture said, thou shalt be saved. And when you're saved, when you receive Him, you are born again. And when you're born again, you're born as God being your Father. Amen? Is there any doubt of those folks who have accepted Christ, whether or not they are the children of the Most High? Hopefully when you leave here tonight, there won't be no doubt. The Holy Spirit bears witness that we are the heirs of God. And if God is truly our Father, then we inherit what He possesses. Amen? I don't think y'all got that. Let me say it another way. What do we possess? We possess all that God has. Amen? Everything that He got belongs to us. We are the heirs of eternal life. We are the heir of salvation. What's better than that? We are the heirs of the promise made to Abraham. The promise to inherit the world and to become the citizen of that great nation of people. We are the heirs of God and shall inherit a great kingdom, the new heaven and the new earth. Galatians 3:29 says, and if you be Christ, then are ye Abraham's seed, and heirs according to the promise. For we are heirs of the glory of God. For the word says, if children, then heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ. If so be that we suffer with Him, that we may be also glorified together. But we are heirs of righteousness. Says by faith, Noah, being warned of God, of things not seen as of yet, moved with fear, prepared an ark to the saving of his house, by the which he condemned the world, and became heirs of the righteousness, which is by faith. But we are of the grace of life. We are children of the Most High. So if we are children of the Most High, then let's claim our inheritance. Let's walk in His peace. Let's live in His grace. Let's be overthrown with His joy. For the Holy Spirit is the one who has sealed us. But He has sealed the truth to our heart. But we have to know that we know that we know that we're saved and that we are the children of God. But He is the earnest of our inheritance. The Holy Spirit bears witness that we are conquerors over suffering. Yes. Anybody need any suffering lately? And as long as we live in a sinful and corrupt world, we will suffer and we will grow. And we will be able or unable to escape suffering. Sin and corruption take their toll upon our body and spirit and pull us ever over toward the grave. But this is not the suffering being spoken of right now. But there is a suffering that is distinct to the true Christian.
Yes.
Talk about the real believers. But there is a suffering that can be called godly persecution. A suffering and these more than being persecuted for some great cause or purpose. For many folks in the world suffer persecution by some of the fellow associates because of their disagreement and toward their dedication to the purpose. But it is this that makes godly persecution different and distinct. For every person in the world who is not godly opposed the Christian believer. The world opposes those that believe in Christ. They oppose it because it is their nature to oppose. A follower of Christ stands for and proclaims righteousness. A follower of Christ denies self. A follower of Christ sacrificed all what that he had for righteousness. It is suffering for the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And this is the point that the scripture is trying to make. If we suffer with Christ in the great cause of God and his righteousness, then we will be glorified with him. But if we suffer with him, we shall also reign with him. But we are the light of the world. If this world doesn't see the light, the world will stay in darkness. The world needs to know how to deal with the sickness. When the doctor says there's nothing that he can do, the world needs to see Christ's work in Christians. Where they can declare as the three Hebrew boys that by God is able, but even if he doesn't, he's still able. And now the world needs to see that how we deal with trouble. That when trouble comes our way, and there are all sorts of trouble in this world, the world needs to know how we can stand strong in the midst of trouble. They need to see God in our lives. They need to know that we have a God that we can call on. That we have a God that we can lean on. The world needs to see that when tragedy hit our home, that we need to be able to stand and say, God knows, and I'm going to trust in him. So the person who is a true follower of Christ proclaims and stands for Christ. Therefore, that he and she suffer the persecution of the world. For we all have a cross to bear. If we're going to follow Jesus Christ, in following Christ, we have to proclaim and claim our inheritance. Say, blessed are ye that when shall men revive you and persecute you and say all manner of evil against you falsely. For my sake, as the word says. But we need to gird up ourselves. And we need to press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling in Jesus Christ. We need to know that the race isn't given to the swift, nor to the strong, but to the one that endured to the end. And as Apostle Paul declares, therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast. When things isn't going your way, when you're feeling down and out, be steadfast. When you don't have the meal money, be steadfast. When someone has scandalized your name, be steadfast. When trouble in your home or on your job, be steadfast and unmovable. You need to always be abounding in the work of the Lord. But it is working for the Lord when you learn to hold your peace and let the Lord fight your battle. handle it. That I'm going to claim my inheritance. I'm going to walk it. I'm going to live it. I'm going to let the world see that I have an inheritance in Jesus Christ. For he died that I may have. That he redeemed me from sin that I may have. By grace, I know that I'm saved. Through faith. But he gave me the gift of God that I may have. And as I look back over my life, that he have never let me down. He have never failed me. He have always picked me up. He have always been my provider. He've always been my shelter in times of storm. He've always made a way out of no way. He've always healed my body. He've always gave me the strength to endure. But I know my Father, he's watching over me. I know that he pricks my heart to tell me to go this way when I want to go that way. I know that he speaks to me in that still small voice when I want to do my name. And he said, no, you need to do my thing. He said, obedience. Claim your inheritance. Claim your inheritance of who you are. 2015. Claim your inheritance. Now, that you are a child of the Most High. Don't let nobody tell you no different. Don't let your inheritance of who you are be predicated on other folks. But know God, know him for yourself. Know that he has a purpose for you, just for you. And the enemy doesn't want you to receive. He doesn't want you to have that inheritance. Doesn't want you to have what's coming to you. But only you, only you, only you can claim it. Nobody can claim it for you. It's your choice. It's your choice to carry the burden or to let the Lord have it. It's your choice to have the peace of God or the worry of the world. It's your choice. Somebody, God had to choose somebody to go through stuff that other folks will be able to be in church and seeing them with that. And yet they continue to proclaim Jesus is Lord. Continue to say, God is good. God is good. God is good. They even be in a wheelchair. Somebody need to see that person, that warrior of Christ, being pushed around, and yet they're able to say, God is good. This world is not ours. So don't get comfortable. Amen. Amen. Claim your inheritance. I'm going to ask you to stand. And as you stand, I'm going to ask you to make your way to the altar. And as we approach the threshold of 2015, getting ready to leave 2014. And as we look back on some times we have had and how God brought us through, as we look back on the joy when we were on the mountaintop, as well as in the valley, we yet can say God. Right here. 2015. 14 we won't see it no more. After a couple minutes, we're in 2014. Eternal God.
Yeah.
please, don't leave. We have your breakfast. So let's stick around in fellowship for a moment. Let's eat some omelets. And we got a chef in the house, and he's doing it for us.
Yeah,
we got a real chef. Yeah, Chef Brown. Chef
Brown. Yeah, he works at, working a long time. Can't go in today. No, I had been in it, well, I had to go in Monday because they couldn't do payroll. But I've been on leave since the 19th. I worked a little bit. And then I found out Monday, headquarters sent out an email and none of my payroll was done.
I got a boss, he can do it.
But then the AO called me to tell me, he can't do your payroll.
How come he can't be the boss?
Your new boss ain't gonna do it.